One, two, three, one, two. Thank you. Next, the students are learning to strum, and a very common thing that guitars need to learn to play is what we call three-chord rock. So now we're going to give you three examples of three-chord rock, because so many songs use three chords. So first we're going to do three-chord rock in G. One, two, three. Next, we have three-chord rock in D.
One, two, three.
Thank you, and now three-chord rock in A.
One.
We also like to study the blues, and this next one is old-time blues, a song called Corina, Corina, and the students learned to do some finger-picking technique. So some of the students you'll see demonstrating finger-picking technique, and other students are going to play the melody. So don't forget to look, there's that little intro at the beginning, and then there's that little ending thing.
Thank you.
another important melody of the classical repertoire is Bach's Minuet in G. And no beginning class would be complete if you did not hear the Minuet in G. Lydia Soto for reminding me what the next song is. Thank you, Lydia. The students are also learning classical guitar technique, and that involves playing with your alternating fingers. So this next piece is called Aguado Study, and the students will demonstrate a classical guitar technique. We love the blues, and we love learning some basic techniques, and this next one is called the one finger blues, because the students can do a chord technique using one finger, which is really awesome. But this is a three-part ensemble, so you'll hear some students doing a bass line, some students doing the one finger technique, and other students with a little solo riff the second time through.
And one, two, three.
The skills that the students have been learning this year in the beginning guitar class. These guys have been really great to work with. I know Mr. Corey feels exactly the same way about his class, and they have worked really hard. They've been a lot of fun to work with. Of course, the year's not over yet. We still have some things to do before the year's over, but we've really been having a great time this year. They're great students. Okay, so beginners, I want you to carefully, if you have to hand off a guitar to
We always have to play Ramanta, don't we?
Oh, duh. See what I mean? I need somebody to poke me. The next piece we're going to play is a famous Spanish guitar piece called Romanza. And my class will play a version of it first. And then all of us together will start up the book version. Okay, don't forget on the book version, it has the two measures of introduction. So wait for the introduction before you come up to note, right? Okay, but my class will play a version of it first, and then we'll go into the book version second, right? All together now on the count of three. 1, 2, 3. Good job, guys. Be careful on the third row that you don't fall off or knock a chair off. So exchange guitars and guitar ensemble, come on up. Ensemble, and these are students who took beginning guitar and then decided they wanted to keep playing, and so some of them are in it for their second year, and a few are in it for their third year, which is wonderful. You could stay in guitar ensemble all the way through high school. So if you took beginning guitar as a freshman, you could join the guitar ensemble and then stay in it each year because the music is different each year. We'll play three pieces for you tonight. The first one is a classical guitar etude by Matteo Carcassi.
Who wasn't here this morning besides?
Next, we'll play a three-part arrangement of a piece called Morris Dance, which is actually a variation on the word Moorish. So it comes from the Spanish Moors in the southern part of Spain. And it was arranged by Richard Pick, who is a famous classical guitar teacher and arranger. Anyway, this one is Morris Dance in three parts.
Thank you.
wrap up this part of the program with an arrangement of Justin Bieber's Love Yourself. That's a very popular guitar riff. I'm sure you'll recognize it as soon as you hear it.
Are you singing it?
No, you are. Singing it. If you know the words.
Maybe everybody can sing along on the chorus.
Thank you.
So another classic song of the guitar repertoire is the famous Dust in the Wind. And so we're really proud of the beginning classes because they learned the guitar part for that. And this song will feature two of our orchestra students who are also in guitar. Trina Yim and Carlos Alvarez are going to play the violin. All together. Remember, we're going kind of on the slow side, remember? So one and a two and a one and a two and a, right? Okay, so take your time. Ready, here we go. Thank you. I hope you'll join us for some cookies and refreshments, and we'll talk and say hi. Students, thanks.